Hello and welcome back to Math Class in Session. Next up, applications of quadratic equations. What this amounts to is word problems that involve solving quadratic equations. Let's get started. Example, a right triangle has a perimeter of 3 meters. Its hypotenuse is 130 centimeters. What are the lengths of the other sides? Solution, draw a diagram. There's a diagram of a right triangle with a hypotenuse of 130 centimeters. And Pythagoras tells us that the square on the hypotenuse is the sum of the squares of the other two sides. So 130 squared must be x squared plus y squared. That when we add up all the sides, we have to get 3 meters, which is 300 centimeters. Notice the fact that we put 300 centimeters here because the 130 is in centimeters and we have to keep the units consistent. Simplifying this equation, we can pull the 130 over, join it with the 300, and then pull the x over, and we solved for y. And we can take this y and plug it right in to our Pythagorean equation. What we'll do is we'll sub the linear equation, y equals 170 minus x, into the quadratic equation, the one with the squares. And so when we plug in 170 minus x right there for y, it looks like this. Notice we sub the linear into the quadratic. Not the other way around. Bringing this forward and squaring a binomial now. 170 squared, perhaps on a calculator. Double the product will be 340x with a negative sign, and then plus x squared. Collecting like terms and simplifying. And equaling it to zero because now we're solving a quadratic equation and that involves equating to zero. We have 2x squared minus 340x, and when we take 16,900 and subtract it on this side, we get 12,000. And all of this is equal to zero. Because it's equal to zero, we're allowed to divide through by a constant factor like 2. 2 goes into each term, so we can divide through by 2. You can't do this if it says f of x equals 2x squared minus 340x plus 12,000, but you can when that whole quadratic is equal to 0. You can divide through by 2. Factoring, two numbers that multiply to 6,000 that add up to 170 are 120 and 50. So factoring and solving by factoring x equals 120 or x equals 50. And so concluding, thus the other two sides must be 120 and 50. So a reasonable question might be, well, which one is it? Well, if we look and think, if x was 120, then y would be, well, what's left over, that's 50. And if x was 50, y would be what's left over, that's 120. Because remember, they all have to add up to 300. And since those are the same two triangles, if x is 120 and y is 50, it's the same as if x was 50 and y was 120. It's the same triangle, just turned on its side. Example number 2. A number of students charter a bus to go to a football game, like a class of students, for example, at a total cost of $80. The bus fare for the entire bus is going to be $80. On the day, 8 of the students are ill and can't go. Each of the remaining students then has to chip in a bit more. Each of the remaining students has to pay an extra 50 cents to cover for the people who were sick and couldn't go. How many students go on the bus? Solution. Let x represent the number of students that go on the bus. Now we have to build an equation, keeping in mind that x represents the number of students that go on the bus. 80 over x plus 8. Well, x plus 8 is the number of students in the class, not on the bus. X is the number of students on the bus, so x plus 8 is the number of students in the class. So $80 divided by or divided evenly over the number of students in the class was what they were originally going to pay each. But it turns out they have to chip in another 50 cents each. So we'll add 50 cents, and this must turn out to be what they actually paid. And what they actually paid was $80, evenly distributed over the number of people on the bus. So 80 over x. Remember, x represents the number of students on the bus. Maybe this sentence might help. They ended up paying 50 cents more than what they were originally going to pay. What they were originally going to pay was $80 evenly distributed over the number of students in the class, so 80 over x plus 8. That's what they were originally going to pay. Add 50 cents to that, and you have what they actually paid, which is $80 divided by the number of students that actually were on the bus. That's the hard part of this word problem. The rest of it is, well, let's multiply through by the common denominator, x times x plus 8. That would be the common denominator. So everything times x times x plus 8. So x times x plus 8 times this term, and the x plus 8s cancel, and we have 80 times x. X times x plus 8 times this term, and we have this. And x times x plus 8 times this term, and the x's cancel, and we have 80 times x plus 8. Expanding. Now what's happened here is I decided to multiply through by 2, so times 2. Why? Because this is half of x squared, and if I multiplied by 2, I'd have a whole of x squared. So I doubled everything so that I could double this term. 0.5x squared has become 1x squared, which is better because it's easier to work with. But everything else has to be doubled as well. So 80 times 2, 4 times 2, 80 times 2, and 640 times 2. Now when we collect like terms, things simplify a bit. The 160x on the left offsets the 160x on the right. We have x squared plus 8x minus this 1280 because we drag it across this equal sign. Okay, so now it's time to factor. Factoring, thinking of two numbers that multiply to 1280 that are different or that subtract to the number 8. It's 32 and 40, put them into brackets and hit this target of plus 8 by going minus 32 plus 40. That's plus 8. And now concluding, x must be 32 or negative 40. Now considering what x represents the number of students that go on the bus, x can't be negative 40, so x must be 32. And so there were 32 students on the bus. A third question, if the average speed of a light plane had been 40 kilometers an hour less, the plane would have taken 1 hour longer to fly 1,200 kilometers. That makes sense. If you fly slower, it's going to take longer. So if the average speed of a light plane had been slower by 40 kilometers an hour, it would have taken an hour longer to fly the same 1,200 kilometers. What was the original speed of the plane? It's a word problem that involves speed, time, like 1 hour, and distance, 1,200 kilometers. Speed, time, and distance word problem are best solved with a chart. So let's let x represent the speed of this plane while it was going fast. And we know it's speed, time, distance, so we make this chart. Speed, time, distance across the top. So there's three across the top and two down the side. In this case, going fast and going slow. For speed, time, distance problems, there's always two legs of the journey. For example, you might ride a bike and then get in a car and drive. So it would be riding and driving. In this case, going fast and going slow. And we've let X represent the speed of the plane while going fast. So we can put an X in the chart right there. So going slow, or slower than X, if the average speed of a light plane had been 40 kilometers an hour less. So going slow speed would be X, whatever that is, minus 40. The distance in both cases is 1,200 kilometers. And all we have to do is fill in the time. Now the time is filled in with the companion to the chart. We have the chart, which is a 3x2, speed, time, distance, and then two legs along the side here. To fill it in, we need the companion to the chart, and that's this little triangle. Distance is speed times time. But in this case, we want time, which is t, that's distance over speed, so it will be distance, 1,200 over speed. 1,200 over x will go there. And 1,200 over x minus 40 will go there. And now we filled in the chart. Now we have to build an equation. The plane would have taken longer to fly slower. So we can compare their times. Their times. 1,200 over x, 1,200 over x. That's the fast time. So it was smaller, so we have to add 1 to the fast time because the fast time is smaller to make it equal to the slow time, 1,200 over x minus 40. So we have a fast time, which is smaller, adding 1 to it because it says it would have taken 1 hour longer. So we'll add 1 to the smaller number, which is 1,200 over x. The fast time is smaller than the slow time. We'll add 1 to the smaller number. And we'll equal that to the bigger number, which represents the time going slowly. And this equation is by far and away the hardest part of this word problem. Multiplying each and every term by x times x minus 40. We'll clear the fractions and solve. So here it is, every term times x minus 40. X times x minus 40 times this, and the x's cancel, leaving 1,200 times x minus 40. X times x minus 40 times 1, and x times x minus 40 times this term, and the x minus 40 cancels, and we have 1,200 times x. Expanding it out. Noticing 1,200x on both sides offsets, equaling it to 0, putting the x squared term first, then minus 40x, then minus 48,000. And we have to think of two numbers that multiply to 48,000 that are different by 40. A bit of investigation on a calculator will lead you to 240 and 200. When multiplied together, make 48,000, and they're different by 40. Therefore, x equals 240 or x equals negative 200, solving the quadratic. Now, since the plane wasn't flying backwards, we can reject x equals negative 200 and say, therefore, x equals 240, and thus the plane was flying 240 kilometers an hour. A final example, a mat of uniform width is to be placed around a painting so that the area of the matted surface is twice the area of the picture for the painting. If the outside dimensions of the mat are 20 by 30, find the width of the mat. Now it's a uniform width. Solution, draw a diagram. So here we have a picture surrounded by a mat of uniform width. I've made X be the width. Is X along here, it's X along here, see X, it's X along here, it's X along here. It's a uniform width and the width is X. And the entire thing is 20 by 30. Now, we have to think. The matted surface is twice the area of the picture. So all of this shaded area, this mat, is two times this picture. So the entire thing has been divided into three parts. Two of them are in the mat, and one of them is in the picture. So we can make this statement. The area of the picture is one of those three parts, one third of the whole area. But the whole area is 20 by 30. So the area of the picture is one third of 30 times 20, or 20 times 30. Multiplying this out, we get one third of 30, that's 10 times 20, so that's 10 times 20 is 200. So the area of the picture is 200. Now what we need to do is make an expression for the area of the picture. Well, it's a rectangle, so it will be length times width, and the length is 30, take away two x's. There's an x there and there's an x there, so 30 take away two x's will be the length of this picture. While the width of this picture will be 20, take away these two x's. So it's this distance, which is 20, take away two x's. So replacing that expression right here for the area of the picture, 30 minus 2x times 20 minus 2x. And this must be equal to 200. So it took some labor, but we do have now an equation, a quadratic equation to solve. Carrying it forward, multiplying it out, equating it to zero, collecting like terms. Now, because it's equal to zero, and only because it's equal to zero, we're allowed to divide through by 4. And two numbers that multiply to 100 that add up to 25. Well, 20 times 5 is 100. And they add up to 25. And our target is minus 25. So minus 5 minus 20 is minus 25. And so x equals 5 or x equals 20. But 20 is too large. How could x be 20? That was 20 there, and if that was another 20, that's 40, which is bigger than 30. So 20 is too large. As 20 centimeters is too large, the width of the border must be 5 centimeters.